Buffalo Bill Jr.
Buffalo Bill Jr.
Buffalo Bill Jr. with his little sister, Calamity. Buffalo Bill Jr. brings you exciting action. Thrill and fun. Whoa. With Judge Ben Fair and Square, Wiley.
Buffalo Bill.
Came in on the stage. It's for the judge.
What's in it? Hey, knuckles down.
Well, come on inside and find out.
Well, I've got to go now. Thanks for teaching me how to play.
Aren't you going to give him back his marbles?
We played for keeps, and I won these.
Well, I finally arrived, Judge.
Postmark St. Louis. Yeah, this must be it.
Hurry up and open it. Golly, a silver peach pie.
Isn't it a beauty? Not careful, Clem. You'll smudge it with your fingerprint.
Give it to me. I want to see if you got the engraving right. Presented to the Mescalero tribe of the Apache Indian Nation by the people of Wileyville.
Say, if you got the letter ready, I'll take it out to the reservation.
Right there on the cash register. Here, give it to me. We better check it over again. See if it's all right. Greetings to Kitano, chief of the Mescaleros, from the people of Wileyville. In recognition of the 50 years of unbroken friendship, we hereby invite you to come to council in Wileyville on August 2nd to receive a symbol of our enduring brotherhood. Signed, Judge Ben Wiley for the people of Wileyville.
Gee, that sounds mighty impressive.
I can hardly wait to see the chief's face when he hears it.
Who said anything about you going along?
Well, why shouldn't I?
For two very good reasons.
First, I'm a girl, and second, I'm too young.
Right. So?
So try and stop me.
Go get the boys.
Gunshot. Get the rope. Tex, take a look around the back.
Mm-hmm.
Red Wolf up for?
We got this Apache rustling cattle.
No, we not steal white men's cattle.
Shut up. Shut down one of our men, too.
White man shoot Red Wolf first.
I've known him a long time, and I've always known him to speak the truth.
That's right. He's our friend.
Let's take him back to the reservation and leave him as an example.
Turn him loose.
You'll be sorry you butted into this.
One time, Calamity. Now, unbutton your gun belts and drop them on the floor. I'm taking Red Wolf back into town, turning him over to the judge. Any charges you fellas got to make against him, you can make in court.
Reservation, Red Wolf just rode off.
Well, good afternoon, Mr. Gorman.
Hello, Judge. Well, I take it you've heard all about it, the Apache raid on my cattle.
Yeah, Bill just told me.
Did he tell you he was an accomplice to a murder?
Murder?
That's what I said. The man that Apache shot died a few minutes ago.
Red Wolf just shot in self-defense.
Well, since when does the law call it self-defense for a cattle thief to murder men guarding their herds?
I was just trying to stop your men from taking the law into their own hands.
And they caught him red-handed.
Well, every man's entitled to a fair trial, no matter what the color of his skin.
Well, don't let your authority go to your head, Judge. You were elected by a vote of the people, and we can get rid of you just as fast if you start favoring murderous Indians over decent citizens.
I also took an oath of office to uphold the law, and that I intend doing no matter what the personal consequences.
He isn't in jail. I just checked.
What did you do with him?
Sneaked out on you, eh? You and your big talk about turning him over to the law.
Red Wolf just probably stopped by the reservation to get that slug dug out of his arm. He'll turn himself in eventually.
Do you believe that too, Judge?
Yes, I do.
Oh, well, you're having your pipe dreams. We'll do something about it.
What do you intend doing?
What the law should have done. Go out to the reservation and get him.
Mr. Gorman, you better let me talk to him first.
You've done enough talking. There's only one way to treat renegade Indians, with a firm hand. Otherwise, they'll start wholesale killing and raiding like they did under Geronimo.
I just don't understand it. Those Apaches have always been so friendly and peaceful.
Well, they won't be unless I can reach them before Gorman does.
We've just got to.
Now, just a minute. An Apache reservation with Indians liable to go on the war path is
no
place for
a young girl like you.
Well, it isn't. And this time you're staying here. I'm your friend. Take me to Red Wolf.
Why you spy on Apache?
I wasn't spying. I came to warn you that white men are coming to take Red Wolf.
He is my friend. He saved my life.
Why didn't you come to town and give yourself up?
Those white men would have killed me.
The judge and I would have protected you. You disappointed us when you ran away like that. And the Apaches disappointed us when they tried to steal white men's cattle.
Apache not steal. They drive cattle off reservation. White man want to graze herd, but not want to pay money.
Was a white man named Gorman?
Gorman have men drive cattle onto reservation. This Apache land. Do not Apache have right to drive cattle off again?
So that's why he claimed you were rustling.
Gorman and men come.
Wait a minute, Chief. Don't fight them. They'll think this is an Indian uprising and they'll call soldiers in and put you in prison.
Apache warriors not to run away.
There's a better way to settle it. Red Wolf, you know that I'm your friend. Will you trust me? Then come with me to town. Let me put you in jail till we can settle this in court.
To save my people from war, I will go with you, even if I must die.
We'll do our best to prevent that.
We must hurry.
Well, I can't move very fast like this. Quick. I'll meet you in town, and this time don't fail me. Back up here. Back.
Doesn't sound right, does it?
Never mind. Hope you haven't made a mistake relying on Red Wolf.
He gave me his word, and I know I can trust him.
Well, I see that the jail is still empty. Judges ought to convince you how treacherous those Apaches are. If it hadn't been for your interference, we might...
You lock me in jail now, please, Judge?
May I have the honor?
Now, what were you saying, Mr. Gorman?
I'll tell you one thing. The people aren't going to stand for your Indian-loving interference much longer.
Be careful what you say, Mr. Gorman, or I'll have to lock you in jail, too.
You don't scare me. I'm going to take this up at the Indian Bureau. I'll see that those bloodthirsty savages are moved someplace where they can be kept under closer guard.
Did you hear what he said, Bill?
I sure did. Gorman's right about one thing. We've done enough talking. Now we gotta get some evidence that'll back up the Apaches. Aren't you coming?
Who? You mean me?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm too young. I'm a girl.
Well, all right, if you're not gonna come.
Wait till I pick up my marble!
You see? Many hoof marks on us. This Indian land. Hoof marks made by cattle. White man's cattle.
Now, there's no doubt that cattle trample this ground, Chief. But...
You not believe me.
Sure, I believe you. But that's not enough.
Gorman would say that you drove the cattle on the reservation when you tried to steal them.
Apache's not steal.
Well, I didn't mean that. Oh, it's hard to explain, but what we got to prove is that Gorman's men were on Indian land with the cattle herd.
May not know how.
Well, for instance, now you take that hoof print over there. The one with the barred shoe belonged to a horse ridden by one of Gorman's men. All we have to do is trace it back to the ranch.
Then why don't we?
What?
Trace it back to the ranch, that barred hoof print.
Do any of the Indians have horses shod like that?
No, that mark of strange pony.
Well, what are we waiting for, Calamity? Let's get going. Keep a close watch and whistle if anyone starts to come.
Unhitched and into the barn.
You're driving me crazy. Cut it out.
That was just an accident. Here, have some peanuts yourself.
Well, that's just about enough of your kid tricks.
I told you to quit it. What's the matter with you? You're going crazy or something? I didn't do anything.
That did it.
That bar shoe? It's used for curing a shrunken hoof.
Now what do we do? Go get the judge to arrest Gorman?
No, it's not going to be that easy. He could probably lie his way right out of it. We're going to have to pin him down.
Well, what are we going to use for pins?
You.
Me?
You mean they've confessed their guilt?
Oh, I'll explain on the way. We've got to hurry.
Tell Wade I'm going into town.
Get his gun, Calamity.
Well, I never thought a judge's daughter would deliberately lie. He said the Indians were ready to talk.
They are.
And they got ways of making you talk back.
I'll see that the judge hears of this.
We'll save you the trouble. Calamity, go into town and get the judge and bring him out to Serpent Mountain.
Serpent Mountain?
That's right, the Shrine of the Devil Dancers. Get going.
Care what Gorman told you. That girl lead him into trouble. Judge's kids were both in here snooping around. We got to find him.
Rattlesnake bit him. One nick of that arrow hit and you're a dead man.
Stop! Stop him!
You can stop him anytime you want to, Gorman. All you gotta do is tell us the truth.
All right, I'll tell you only stop him before he kills me!
Your cattle herd was on the Indian reservation when the Apache stampeded it, wasn't it?
Yes. They had every right to drive it off. I tried to turn things to my advantage, make it look like they were rustling. I wanted the Indians moved off so that their grazing land would be left open. But I had no part in trying to kill Red Wolf.
He was innocent, wasn't he?
Yes. The men said he was fighting for his life.
Where's Gorman?
At the Indian shrine. He just admitted his guilt.
Yeah? Well, I'll have to hear about that from him. Wait! Basham!
It's a great honor to present you this silver peace pipe as a perpetual symbol of our enduring brotherhood.
Thank you in name of Muscalero Apache. I accept. Now we smoke together.
May I see the pipe? A marble. Calamity.
Me, I don't know how it got in there.
Now with his horse and with his gun, he's not afraid of anyone. 'Cause no one's quicker on the draw or quicker to defend the law.
Buffalo Bill Jr., Buffalo Bill Jr.
He's the son of a gun.
Buffalo Bill.